Hello! Come on in! Velkommen til vårt hjem. Welcome to my home.
Well, come in and sit by the fire. It's very cold outside. Come and set a spell. Would you like a cup of coffee?
Yeah, sure.
That's what we offer people in here in Minnesota, the Scandinavian drink. Well, my name is Kari Tauring, and I live here in Minneapolis with my husband, Greg, and our two sons, Oscar, who is almost 14, and Jack, who is almost 12. It's Monday morning, and so I'm going to take you through sort of a typical day of what I do for a living. I have a radio interview about my book, The Runes, A Human Journey. Even though it's on the radio, it's good to have a few things to show the interviewer. I might bring, for example, some of the runes that I've made and let her just sort of pull one at random and kind of explain what it means. And then Thursday evening, I will be playing music, some selections from my CD, Volua Songs, that I put out in May 2008. And while I don't speak fluent Norwegian, I have a few friendly phrases that I've learned from my grandmother so that I can at least be a polite non-Norwegian speaker. So this Saturday, then, I will be doing the opening ceremony for the Art Shanty Project, which is artistic ice fishing houses, and I will use my staff. And later today I need to go to my father's workshop. He has a wood shop, and finish making my sled. I'm doing a kick sled and some staving, and we'll be singing in the quarters. So this is a pretty typical week for me.
Well, let me get the car scraped off. I'm really glad this show is taking place in May, June in Norway instead of winter solstice time.
It's a good thing I like cross-country skiing. I know that's, you know, you need to have good winter sports when you live in this climate. Of course, in the summertime, I love to go canoeing. I like to steer the canoe while Greg does the fishing. I'm not as much of a fisherman, but I love to cook fish up.
Come on in. This is Ingebretsen's. This is sort of the mecca of Scandinavian Americans in the Midwest. They drive for miles and miles to come here. And Ingebretsen's has been a major supporter of my work, and the classroom space next door is where I do a lot of my teaching. And this is the oldest section of Ingebretsen's, which is the meat market.
Hi there.
Hi, how are you?
Good.
Good. Okay, now if I were going to go on a Norwegian reality show and they wanted to challenge me to eat something, would you have any examples of what that might be that I might not eat unless someone was paying me?
Well, they probably have like a gumlost.
Yeah, what's gumlost?
That's old rotten cheese.
Cheese.
They have sousstrømming, that's an old rotten fish.
Yeah.
And but neither one of those I can even get you because they don't let them into the country.
Don't tell anyone from Minnesota, but I'm not that fond of lefse, and it's kind of almost blasphemous, but I think my Norwegian ancestry predates potatoes.
All right.
This is what is so remarkable about the opportunity to be part of this show. I know so much stuff, and people have assumed that I must have studied in Norway for years and years, and I've never been there. And this is just the opportunity that I need. So in conclusion, I would like to share just a little bit of kulning while yawling in Norwegian. Mom used to do on the farm in Wisconsin. She'd call the cows.